Hello, everybody. Master Gary Hernandez here. I had a company in Germany, and I'm not even going to try to say their name because it's about 14 letters long, and I'm really going to tear it apart. But on the photos and the information I did last night on this self-defense unbreakable umbrella, their name is there. So I'm going to have to learn how to pronounce it, obviously. They're from Germany, like I said, and they sent me a umbrella that's a self-defense unbreakable one. And they wanted me to go ahead and kick the tires on it and give some feedback on it. They'd like me to go ahead and be one of their representatives in the United States and sell their umbrella because they know that I do a lot of self-defense with improvised weapons and I use umbrellas and canes and stuff like that. So they contacted me a couple weeks ago. We talked a little bit. And they sent me out the umbrella, which I actually received yesterday. Now, I did some photos of it, and I put down the information of this umbrella that they sent me also, so everybody could read about it. Now, this umbrella, from what they're telling me, is going to be able to hold about 80 kilograms, and the conversion of that, I believe, is 176 pounds. I'll double check that. Now that's a lot of weight bearing down, so I'm not sure if they mean bearing down on it or if they mean physical impact coming in. So I'm going to kick the tires on it. So the test I'm going to do, right now this is just a small video to show you guys this. The test I'm going to do with it besides, and I'm going to start off with something a little smaller, stepping on it, see how much weight it bears, and then I'm going to beat the bags with it and see how it closes and opens and make sure it stays to what they say is true. Now, the umbrella itself is a very beautiful umbrella. First thing I like about it, and let me first start off by talking about, yes, the cost is, for what a lot of people in the United States feel, is high. That I already said in the post I did yesterday. With their conversion kit, it's somewhere in the neighborhood of 120, give or take. I'm going to talk to them and see if I can work that cost down, because if I'm going to sell it down here in the U.S., to be realistic with everybody, yes, I need to make a profit of me selling this. I'm just not going to do it for free, because then I'm doing time, effort, and stuff like that. So I want to be able to sell it at a pretty reasonable cost. Now understand, first off, to me, for a high-quality umbrella, not to mention one that's going to hold up for self-defense and supposedly unbreakable, I feel that's a good price. A lot of people, not so much. But I've spent hundreds of knives and hundreds of dollars on canes. So, and it's that old scenario, you pay, or you know, you basically get what you pay for. So you want a high quality umbrella that's unbreakable, it's going to be up there somewhat. But again, I'm going to see what I can do about the cost. But enough of that. Now, the umbrella itself, it is beautiful. Number one, I like the handle that comes with the case. You can sling it over your shoulder. You can open it up through here and swing it around you as though you were carrying a katana. But it's a good hand. It's a good case built into the handle itself. I'm sorry. It's basically nicely designed into it. So it's just not, you know, sewn on there cheaply. It's very well stitched. So it's going to hold. Case comes off. Now the umbrella, it's a nice length. It makes a good walking stick. But some of the things you're going to notice, number one, has a steel tip, and that's solid steel. That makes great for lunging into the ribs, into a throat. Now, the knob is solid wood. I'm going to have to find out exactly what wood they use on that one, but that's extremely solid. It comes, besides coming in a regular wood tone of brown, it comes in a black. Now, you can also get this in a regular horn fashion, but that's a little bit more money. The one with the knob's a little cheaper. So it's very, very elegant looking, like they say. Now, holding it and feeling it, I already can tell it's stronger and tougher. than my regular umbrellas. So I already know that. I can't really bend it. So it's already solid. Again, I'll kick the tires on it on another video. Now, has your snap here. And what I like about it, it's a one finger touch. Opens right up. Now, first thing I noticed when I opened this umbrella was how big it is inside. It's obviously going to keep the rain off of you and probably two other people, and the sun as well. To show you the size of it, it's pretty big. It's not a small umbrella by far. And from what I was reading about it and what they were explaining it to me, it handles great with wind, so it's not gonna fold as easy as a lot of umbrellas. No, I did not try it in a hurricane. It's gonna repel rain, snow, anything off it, really. Even sun hitting is not gonna hit you. So it's a great umbrella. It closes, well, I'm showing the inside. Now, they haven't told me exactly how they designed everything inside for strength, what they're exactly using. I don't know if they want to tell me all that until after I decide to be a representative of the United States for them. I understand that. It closes extremely easy. Again, one hand opening. It's a really beautiful umbrella. Snaps back. And again, it's great. It takes a lot of impact, they say, from swinging. I'm gonna have some big students swing at me, and I'm gonna see what kind of impact it takes, and I'm gonna open it up and check that out. It's great for blocking, striking. Now, those of you that know me and been in my classes where I work umbrella self-defense, besides using an umbrella, obviously, as a thrusting weapon or a long-range hitting weapon, I have the umbrella enclosed, and I use it as an enclosed fighting stick. And this right here is perfect and solid for hitting those joint areas, smacking upside the head, going into the throat. I can go in here and long range out, thrust. So this umbrella feels solid. Again, I'm going to test it. But it moves very well. I've been working out with it a little bit today. I did hit the bag a little bit, no problems. But I want to be able to have a student here, and I'll hit the bag on a video and have a student take a couple swings, close it, open it, and I'll do the test with you guys. But again, the self-defense unbreakable umbrella, I do know other companies have made some because I've seen them before. But this one here, like I said, is very beautiful. Again, very functional, and it'll do what's needed to be done. So basically, if you're looking for, it's what you're looking for. Let me tell you the pros and cons real quick. Pros. Number one, fully functional umbrella with a wide area to stop rain, sun, snow. Also, unbreakable self-defense umbrella. Very nice looking. You can carry it anywhere. Doesn't have a knife or a sword or nothing like that. Now, the only cons are two. One of them is a lot of people like to have a smaller umbrella so they can keep it in their car side or keep it in their purse. I understand that. So if you're looking for a little umbrella, this one is not for you. On the other con is the cost. I know a lot of people will not want to pay $120-something for an umbrella. But you got to look at what you're buying. You're buying an elegant umbrella, you're buying a full functional umbrella, and you're buying an unbreakable self-defense umbrella. So basically, I'm going to work on trying to get the price down so I can pass the savings to you guys and maybe get this cost down a little bit. I'll work with them, see what they can work with me. But I'm going to kick the tires on it some more, and I'll see where we go with it. But Master Gary Hernandez will review on the self-defense unbreakable umbrella.